Hello, I welcome you all to the presentation related to belt, rope and chain drives. In this particular lecture, we will be discussing various types of belt drives, their constructions, different types of tensions in the belts, initial tension and finally the selection of the belt drive from manufacturer's catalogue. Contents of this lecture are types of belt, materials and construction of belt drive, flat belt, geometrical relationships for belt drives, analysis of belt tensions, initial tension in the belt, selection of belt from manufacturer's catalog, and finally basic procedure for selection of belt from manufacturer's catalog, specifically Dunlop. Types of belts. There are four basic types of belt: flat belts, V belts, circular belts or rope drives, and timing belts. This figure shows the various cross sections of the above belts. The first figure shows round belt, second shows the cross section of V belt, third shows the flat belt, and fourth shows the toothed belt or timing belt. Flat belts. The flat belts are rectangular in cross section. In flat belts, the width of the belt is substantially higher than the thickness of the belt. They can be used to transmit a moderate amount of power from one pulley to another when the two pulleys are not more than 15 meters apart. In flat belt drives, the pulleys are provided with proper crowning to avoid coming off the belt from the pulley. Such pulleys are known as ground pulleys. V belts. The V belts are trapezoidal in cross section. They can be used to transmit large amount of power from one pulley to another when the two pulleys are relatively close to each other. In V belt drives, the pulleys are provided with a groove. Such pulleys are known as grooved pulleys or sheaves. Circular belts or ropes. The circular belts or ropes are circular in cross section. They can be used to transmit large amount of power from one pulley to another when the two pulleys are not more than 5 meters apart. In circular belt drive also, the pulleys are provided with a groove. Timing belts. The timing belts or toothed belts transmit the power by means of teeth rather than friction, hence there is no slip. Timing belts require toothed wheels or sprocket. This figure shows these are the sprockets or toothed wheels, and this is the timing belt or toothed belt. So there is a similar action like gears, and the power is transmitted due to the direct contact between the teeth. Materials and construction of flat belts. Desirable properties of the belt material are high coefficient of friction. Since the belt operates on the concept of friction, more the friction, more the power, hence it should have high coefficient of friction. Second, high flexibility. Third, durability and a good strength. The commonly used materials for the belts are leather, fabric, rubber and polyester or polyamides. There is a specific term, ply of the belt. All of us have heard about a plywood. What a plywood consists of? It consists of thinner wooden plies which are binded together to get a resultant which has a good strength. In the same way, in order to make a practically thick belt, the layers of belt material are cemented together. These layers are called plies of the belt. The belts are specified according to the number of players or plies, that is single ply, double ply or triple ply belts. The power rating of the belt is also specified per ply of the belt. So this is the example of 4 ply leather belt. You can see here there are 4 plies which are binded together, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So hence it is known as 4 ply leather belt. The leather is the material used for it. So hence it is 4 plies of leather belt. Now let us see the construction of polyester belt. There is a tension ply made up of polyester cord is sandwiched between the friction plies at the bottom and the top. Hence it is called as polyester belt. In polyamide belts, the polyester strip is replaced by polyamide strip and it is mounted in between the upper and lower friction ply. Geometrical relationship for belt drives. So there are two types of flat belt drives, open and cross belt drive. In case of open belt drive, the driven pulley rotates in the same fashion as the driver pulley rotates. So here in this figure, the driving pulley is rotating in clockwise direction and the driven pulley is also rotating in the clockwise direction. Whereas in case of cross belt drive, driving and driven pulley rotate in the opposite direction. In this example, the driving pulley is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, whereas we can see the driven pulley is rotating in clockwise direction. So for open belt drive, let us consider alpha S, wrap angle for smaller pulley in degrees, alpha B, wrap angle for bigger pulley in degrees, capital D, diameter of bigger pulley in mm, small d, diameter of the smaller pulley in mm, capital Z, center distance. In some of the books, alpha is denoted by theta. Here in our case, we have denoted wrap angle as alpha. Hence, the angle of contact or angle of lap, or it is also called as angle of wrap, is calculated as for the smaller pulley equal to 180 minus 2 into sine inverse of capital D minus small d upon 2c, whereas for the bigger pulley it is equal to 180 plus 2 into sine inverse of capital D minus small d upon 2c. Similarly, length of the belt for open belt drive is equal to L equal to 2c plus pi into capital D plus small d upon 2 plus capital D minus small d the whole square upon 4c. For cross belt drive, angle of wrap or angle of lap or angle of wrap is calculated as below. For the smaller as well as bigger pulley, the angle of contact is same and is equal to 180 plus 2 into sine inverse of d plus small d upon 2c. Length of the belt is equal to 2c plus pi into d plus d upon small, 2, small d by 2 plus capital D plus small d the whole square by 4c. Here you can note the difference. In case of open belt drive, we have here minus, whereas in case of cross belt drive, here we have plus. So this is the difference between the expression for length of the belt for open belt drive and cross belt drive. Crowning of pulleys. In a flat belt pulley, the rim surface is made of a convex shape by increasing the thickness of the rim at the center. This increased thickness is called crown and the process is known as crowning of the pulley. The crowning helps to keep the belt near the mid plane of the pulley in running position. This avoids slipping of the belt from the pulley. Here in this figure we can see the difference between the flat pulley and pulley with the crown. Here in the case of flat pulley, we have completely flat surface all over the width, whereas in case of crown pulley, here we can see the thickness of the pulley is increased by a small amount h, which is known as crown height. So this increased amount of pulley thickness gives initial tension, increases the initial tension in the belt and helps avoids the slipping of the belt from the made of the pulley. In the second diagram also we can see here clearly, in case of flat belt there is uniform thickness all over the width of the pulley, whereas here at the mid the thickness has been increased from T to the H. So the total thickness at the mid section will be T plus small h. Now, analysis of the belt tensions. Let P1 be the belt tension in the tight side in newtons, P2 be the belt tension in the loose side or slack side in newtons, small m mass of 1 meter length of the belt in kg per meters, and small v is belt velocity in meters per second, small f is coefficient of friction, and alpha is angle of lap or wrap for the belt in radians. So let us consider this pulley. If we have considered a smaller cross section with subtending an angle of delta d phi or delta phi at the center, P2 is the slack side whereas P1 is the tight side. So P2 is the tension on the slack side, P1 is the tension on the tight side. So therefore here pulley is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. So frictional force as it opposes the motion of the pulley will act in the clockwise direction. Dn represents the normal reaction on this small portion of the belt which we have considered for the analysis. Then mv square into d phi, this represents the centrifugal force or centrifugal tension on this smaller amount of belt cross section which we have considered for the analysis. P is the tension on the slack side, whereas P plus dP is the tension on the tight side. Now we know that centrifugal tension is given as Pc equal to m into v square, and it will always act away from the center of the pulley, and hence it will try to throw away the belt from the pulley surface. Hence the net tension on the tight side will be P1 minus mv square. Similarly on the slack side it will be P2 minus mv square. So this ratio P1 minus mv square upon P2 minus mv square, that will be equal to e raised to f into alpha. In the sum of the books, it is P1 is represented as T and f is represented as mu and alpha is represented as theta. So that in that case the equation will be T1 minus mv square upon T2 minus mv square equal to e raised to mu theta. Now if we neglect the centrifugal tension effect, then the ratio of the belt tensions will be P1 upon P2 is equal to e raised to f into alpha. With the other notations it will be T1 upon T2 equal to e raised to mu theta. Please remember this alpha is nothing but it is the angle of wrap on the smaller pulley in radians. Please note this very carefully. If we take this on the bigger pulley, then this belt tension ratio will be wrong. It is always considered on the smaller pulley. Now power transmitted will be equal to P1 minus P2 into the belt velocity, that will be in watts. In kilowatts it will be P1 minus P2 into V upon 1000. Now initial tension in the belt, very important concept. When the belt is mounted on the pulleys, it is provided with certain amount of tension in it. This tension in the belt is known as initial tension. The tension is required to provide a firm grip between the belt and the pulleys. It is calculated by the equation PI, I stands for initial tension, equal to P1 tight side tension plus P2 slack side tension plus twice of PC centrifugal tension by 2. Now condition for the maximum power. The optimum velocity of the belt for the maximum power transmission is given by V is equal to square root of PI upon 3M, where M is the mass of the belt. Now condition for the maximum power based on the belt strength and the friction capacity. So the optimum velocity of the belt for maximum power transmission is given by V is equal to square root of P max upon 3M, and PC centrifugal tension has to be equal to maximum tension into the belt divided by 3. So conclusions, the condition for maximum power transmission is the maximum permissible tension in the belt should be 3 times the tension due to the centrifugal force, that is P max equal to thrice of PC. Alternatively, the tension in the tight side of the belt should be twice the tension due to centrifugal force, that is P1 equal to twice of PC. Alternatively, the belt velocity should be V is equal to square root of P max upon 3M. Now let us see selection of belt from manufacturer's catalogue. So for the selection of a proper belt for a given application, the following information is required. First, the power to be transmitted. Second, the input and output speeds. Third, the center distance depending upon the availability of the space. And fourth, type of the load. The maximum power transmitted by the belt is obtained by the equation Kw max equal to Fa into Kw, where Kw max is power transmitted by the belt for the design purpose and Kw is the actual power transmitted by the belt driven for a given application, and Fa is known as load correction factor. The power transmission capacities of the belt are developed for 180 degree arc of contact. When arc of contact is less than 180 degrees, the power transmission capacity of the belt will reduce, and this is accounted by arc of contact factor Ft. So this table lists load correction factors for different types of loads. For normal load, we have load correction factor 1. For the steady load like centrifugal pump, fans, light machine tools and conveyors applications, we have value of Fa equal to 1.2. For intermittent loads like heavy duty fans, blowers, compressors, reciprocating pumps, line shafts and heavy duty machines, the value of Fa is 1.3. Whereas in case of shock load, that is in case of vacuum pumps, rolling mills, hammers and grinders, the load correction factor is taken as 1.5. Similarly, arc of contact factor Fd for the lap angle on the smaller pulley, the load arc of contact factor is listed as in this table. So, for example, for alpha is equal to 120 degrees, Fd is 1.33. For 130 degrees, it is 1.26. Likewise, for 200 degrees, it is 0.94. We can see as the lap angle is increasing, the value of correction factor decreases. There are two varieties of Dunlop transmission belts. One is high speed duct belting, which is generally general power transmission purpose belting, and second is port duct belting, which is commonly used for heavy duty applications. The power transmission capacities of the belts are: for high speed applications or high speed duct belting, it is given as 0.0118 kilowatt per mm width per ply, and for port duct belting, it is given as 0.0147 kilowatt per millimeter width per ply. The power rating or load rating of flat belts is defined as the power transmitting capacity of the belt per mm width per ply at 180 degree arc of contact. Now the preferred diameters of the cast iron and mild steel pulleys are as follows. So these are the values which are preferred diameters for the belt pulleys: 100, 112, 125, 140, 160, 180, 200, 224, 250, 280, 315, 355, 400, 450, 500, 560, 630, 710, 800, 900 and 1000. Now let us see the basic procedure for selection of belt from manufacturer's catalog. Here we will be referring the Dunlop catalog for the selection. The optimum belt velocity of Dunlop belt ranges from 17.8 to 22.9 meters per second. So we have to assume some velocity, such as 18 meters per second in its range, and we have to calculate the diameter of the smaller pulley using the following relationship. That is, d is the diameter of the smaller pulley equal to 60 into 1000 into v upon pi n, where n is the input speed or rpm of the smaller pulley and v is the belt velocity, which we have assumed as 18 meters per second in this case. The diameter of the bigger pulley is obtained by following relationship: capital D equal to small d into speed of smaller pulley upon speed of the bigger pulley, that is equal to smaller d into input speed upon output speed. Now modify the values of pulley diameters to the nearest preferred numbers, which we have seen in the last slide. Now determine the correct belt velocity for modified values and check whether the actual velocity is in the range of optimum belt velocity. So in this case, we need to calculate the pulley diameter considering v as 18 meters per second. Then after that, we have to calculate the smaller d diameter on the smaller pulley, and from that we need to calculate the diameter of the bigger pulley. And this diameter of the bigger pulley we need to standardize using the preferred numbers. And once we standardize, again we have to find out the belt velocity for modified values, and we have to check whether this actual velocity which we have modified lies in this range from 17.8 to 22.9 meters per second. Next, determine the load correction factor FA from the table 13.1, the table number 13.1, which we have seen in the last slide, and calculate the max by following relationship. So Kw max equal to FA into Kw. Next, calculate the angle of wrap for the smaller pulley using following relationship and find out the arc of contact factor FT from the next table 13.2. So alpha s for the smaller pulley, 180 minus 2 into sine inverse of capital D minus small d upon 2c. Next, calculate the corrected power by the following relationship: Kw corrected equal to Ft into Kw max. Then calculate the corrected power rating for the belt by the following relationships: for high speed belt, corrected kilowatt rating equal to 0.0118 V upon 5.08. And for fourth belt, corrected kilowatt rating equal to 0.0147 V upon 5.08, where V represents the correct belt velocity in meters per second. Next, calculate the product of width into number of plies by dividing the corrected power by the corrected kilowatt rating, or width into number of plies equal to corrected power upon corrected belt rating, that is equal to kilowatt corrected upon corrected kilowatt rating of the belt. Next, calculate the belt width by assuming a suitable number of plies. In this step, there are a number of alternative solutions. A belt width which is near to the standard value is the optimum solution. For this belt, select the standard belt width. Then the last step, calculate the belt length by using the following relationship: L equal to 2C plus pi into t plus small d upon 2 plus capital D minus small d the whole square upon 4c. Thank you for your attention.